Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Heaven's Vault. This is a narrative adventure game that I've been keeping my eye on for quite a while. It's a weird mix of ancient and sci-fi, and I thought it might fit the channel quite well. So, without further ado, let's just double check that the subtitles are on. Subtitles, and I'm gonna lower that down so I can read what's going on. So let's jump in.
Stories don't have tidy beginnings. The past is always present. But there has to be a spark. Something that brings the past to light.
Please, climb carefully. You worry too much. I mean, what am I going to do? Fall? Take a moment to rest before you walk. Mistress, please. Oh, we have a health bar. Okay, I didn't expect that. Now, I'm gonna start this by saying I apologize for all of the mispronunciations. A lot of these words are, well, new to me, and they'll be coming up on the screen. And then what I expect to happen is for me to say it wrong, and then a cutscene to say it in a completely different way, but we'll find out. I'll try my best. If the text speed's too slow, I'll speed it up, but for now I need to give myself enough time to read what's on the screen. A bricked up opening. There is something here. To keep people out, do you think? Or to keep something in? There's something written here. Ancient script. This must have been cut in when the mortar was still wet. But I think I can read it. University of Iox, some weeks earlier.
My story begins on Iox. That was where I met the robot.
Mistress Aelia? Mistress Aelia Elazra? I have been waiting for you. I have been asked to escort you to Professor Mayari. She is very anxious for your arrival. So if I press, what's this? I can press back. Professor Mayari wants to me back on Iox. Hopefully I'm not getting thrown out of the university. The Holy Empire was, Okay, so we have like this timeline. I imagine that we're gonna have to learn all of this, I guess. Oh dear. Okay, we'll worry about that as it comes up. Okay, so and you are. Oh, and who are you? I am a robot, mistress. As is apparent. This way. Oh. You have a name, robot? Is that intended to be a joke, mistress? No? Robots do not have names. We are, as I understand it, interchangeable. So, why has she sent you? Did you do something wrong? That seems unlikely. My ethical core protects me from serious error. This way. You should know that the professor's urgency was remarkable. So I can look at her or I can reply. Let's reply. Maybe we should keep her waiting. Don't want her making a habit of impatience. I cannot recommend that course, mistress. So there's two reply buttons here. I think one is a question, and the other is just a straight-up response. I think I took too long for the question. They can't be giving me another robot. They normally wait for me to lose the ones I'm given. I beg your pardon, mistress. Why is Mayari's room so far from everything? I imagine she enjoys her view of the tree, mistress. I am sure it is most pleasing to her. Okay, let's look at her. Look at her. She looks like a tiger in a cage. A most curious analogy, mistress. You understand I will be required to report it. Uh-oh. Required to? Of course. Professor Mayari is my primary user, mistress. Nevertheless, I will try to sugarcoat your opinion. Great. Good to know you've got my back. Shall we proceed? Question. What is your ethical core, anyway? What good is it? It is what stops me from pushing humans off cliffs, mistress. Is that something you want to do? Push humans off cliffs? It was simply an example, mistress. Were it to be convenient for me to do so, my core would prevent me. Seems good to know. Yeah, so the Tree of Knowledge. Or so they call it. Each branch grows more branches. Except for the ones that die, fall off, and are forgotten. Which is where we come in, I suppose. I went outside the university grounds once, exploring. This is a very beautiful moon.
You can tell it was once lush, fertile. There must have been huge forests, lakes, rivers. They're all but dry now. You've not been outside? No.
Wow, that was blunt. Okay, no, he's never been outside.
What do you think of that sculpture over there? It has a pleasing balance to it. You think it was worth the time it took to make? When there are people on Elboreth who don't eat? Are your own exploits worth the time they take, Mistress? Should we not be making history rather than reviewing it? If you don't know history, you can't understand people. You can starve them or oppress them, but you won't understand them.
A solid viewpoint. Okay, I guess we'll
I
go.
I was 15 when Mayari rescued me from the slums of Elboreth and brought me here. I'd never seen such luxury or such kindness. I still don't know why she did it.
Professor Mayari? Alia! There you are. Come in. I came as soon as I got your message.
Kind of. Stood outside for a bit.
You don't need to flatter me, Alia. Nonetheless, I'm glad you came. I know your work is important to you.
My work is important to everyone. Let's go with, I'll do what I can to help you, Professor.
I'm not sure if the choices are timed, which is why I'm going a bit quick. Thank you, Alia. I appreciate your kindness. You're our expert on history. Tell me what you make of this.
It's certainly old.
Empire period. The device is the Eagle and Sun. One of the scholars sent this brooch to me. Janiqui Renbar. Did you know him? Did? Look at the detail. I see them. Ancient markings. I know they're a hobby of yours, Alia. But can you read them?
Oh, hello.
Okay, short answer, no, I can't. I've never seen either of these groupings before. But the two words have some common elements. So they must have related meanings. Well?
Oh, so I have two options. It can either mean friend or holy. Or Emperor and Beloved. Or Friendly Beloved. Friend Beloved doesn't really make sense, does it? So I'm going to go with Holy and Emperor. And hope that that's the right answer? I don't know. Is he going to tell me? Because if I'm the only person who can read it,
I guess we'll find out. Holy Emperor? But I'm only guessing. You don't think this actually belonged to an emperor? Do you? That would make this the find of a decade. Now, perhaps you see why you're here. Janiqui told me he'd found something that was more than a month ago. Janiqui isn't like you. He's an Oxian through and through. Worried about him? He's important to me. And I don't know what he was doing out there. He told me he was going to a moon called Maesri. I can't go hunting the nebula for missing people, Aelia. But you can. That's what you do, isn't it? Find things? I'll see what I can dig up. Nice pun, I guess. Thank you. Come back when you've found him, Aelia. And Aelia, you're taking that robot with you. Thank you, Professor. I long to see the nebula. I trust this robot. Oh, and before you go, you should look in on Huyang. He was eager to see you. Ego, why? Aelia, really? I couldn't possibly imagine. I know he's rather beneath you. But you could at least say good faith to him. Oh, for the benefit of our little community. I'll go find him. He's down there, by the tree. Oh, the guy in the orange coat? You must have walked straight past him on your way in. Oh. Good hunting, my dear. Okay, let's go speak to Huyang. Question. Would you recognize Renba if we saw him? Did you meet him? I believe he activated me, Mistress, after I was uncovered. I suspect that is why Professor Mayari assigned me to you. Wait, what? Uncovered? You're like prehistoric robot? You're before this time period? Okay, intriguing. Can I just say, Mistress Aelia, it is wonderful to be accompanying you. Oh yes. And why is that? I find humans fascinating. And you are very different to most here. I have only recently been activated. I'm calling you Six. Six, Mistress. I shall remember that. Hey, he has a name now. I wonder if I got Mayari's translation correct. Uh-oh. I think I did. Wonderful. The shape shows this is an empire piece. So, emperor. That was correct. And the emperors believed themselves to be gods. So it makes sense that the words would be almost the same. Holy. Wonderful. So we do find out, but it still doesn't tell me. Where did this thing come from? So we learned the ancient word for holy. We can question him. So, you were really dug out of a wall on Eox? Hyox? I'm going to interchange that repeatedly. I believe I was removed from a wall. The exact events are hazy. Removed from a wall? They dug you out of a wall? Why were you in a wall? Aelia, tell me you are still wasting your time on your curious notions of history. This guy just came up to me and started talking to me. I was very confused. Mayari wants me to find Janiqui Renbar. You haven't lured him into archaeology as well, have you? He was always so devout. What do you mean? Well, now, your ideas are hardly wholesome. All that death and decay. You should devote yourself to a real science. Metallics, maybe. Loop, philosophy. I don't know why I said metallics really weird then, but I did. History is a science. There's robots in walls. Sounds scientific. It's the exploration of the past through evidence and theory. Honestly. Yeah, bugger off. I think this is the man we're looking for. Most people think you will not be content until you have unearthed your own skull. Good faith to you, Aelia. May the waters of your light your way. Oh my! I'm being pulled all over the place. I didn't know you were back on Eox. Okay, so this is the man we were looking for. That other guy was just... I don't know who that was. How are you, Hoyang? Well enough. Well enough. I've been reading all day. I just came outside to rest my eyes. And there you were. And now I've got to go. No. What are you reading? The Annals. Again. Did you know? Mazwai claims the Holy Empire was founded by three wolves racing to heaven. Each one tore the throat of the other, and as the three fell to earth. Are you really interested? Absolutely. Sounds amazing. Knowledge is power and all that. All right. Most people glaze over.
He began to talk with such passion that his eyes glittered, and he seemed to grow at least an inch taller.
Aelia? That was fascinating. There's hundreds of volumes like that. Sometimes I think there are three stories to explain everything, and none of them agree. Other times, I think there's just one story that gets retold for every occasion. I'll walk you to the dock. Huyang, do you know Janique Renba? But I know Renba, of course. Well, a little. Why? What did he teach? He's a roboticist. One of the best. One of the few. Did you say did? Something happened to Janique? I'll let you know. We're on a mission. By the waters. Before you go, it hardly seems important now, but I found a line of ancient in the annals of Mazwe I thought you might like. If you have time, that is. Always. Here, see what you think. Also, we know that says Empress. We don't know what the other two words are. I know one of these words. I'll have to guess the other two. Empress? Banished or buried? Rebels, metals, powers, or robots? Now, is it pictographic in any way? I don't think so. Not to, like, ways that I think, anyway. I mean, as soon as I start to learn a few of them, like, we know that that's... That other word, which I somehow can't get to now. Empress has the squiggly things with the... An upside-down Y with a squiggle on top. So does that word. Which makes me think that it's going to be an important thing. I'm going to go with buried robots, because he said he got dug out of a wall. And it's a really long word for... Banished rebels? I'm going to go with buried robots. I don't know if I'm ever going to find out if that's right or not, but... The Empress buried robots? I think that's correct. So an empress buried the robots here? It's quite a discovery, Huyang. Maybe it is. Maybe you've read it wrong. Oh. I'd best not keep you. I hope you find him. I'm guessing there was predetermined... conversation pieces to whatever I picked. Shall we proceed to your ship now? You sailed before six. I have no idea, mistress. But I am keen to find out. And so we left the hallowed walls of the university. Ah, now we get to see a timeline of what happened while we were here. That just in case I wasn't paying attention, I guess. I'm sure this will come into play later on. Let's continue. Aboard the Nightingale. My ship is my refuge. It's the only place that's truly mine, and it has a wonderful name. Nightingale. The journey to Mesri should be quick, Mistress. Nice place, is it? I do not believe so, Mistress. I believe it is a farmyard. Why does a roboticist go to a farm? To study the competition, perhaps? Or perhaps there are robots buried on Mesri. Maybe. I mean, are there robots buried on Mesri? You never know, we might know. Most likely not. Oh. It is a moon of pigs and rice, Mistress. Part of the Iox Protectorate, of course. Maybe Mesri will have a few ruins of its own. Can learn about letters. That seems unlikely. God damn it, man, you're such a downer. But it is not wealthy. Nonetheless, I will prepare the ropes. Okay, where next? Choose a location and plot a course. I guess there isn't many locations here, unless we're going to suddenly discover more, which I imagine we will. Let's go. Oh, it's where Janqui told the Professor Mario was going right before he disappeared. But why does a roboticist visit a rice farm? I may have missed a bit of text there. I could go there next. I mean, you could. Wait, so I can go here instead? Elbereth is my home. It's where I moor up when I want to sleep well. But not today. Okay, maybe I can't. Let's sail. I wonder how the sailing works. What are we sailing on? The sea? We're talking about the nebula. Are these spaceships? Moons and things. It's got to be moons. We've got to be in space. Sailing to Mesri in the Verdant Pass.
Maiari wanted us to sail to Mayerzi. It was a short sail through fast waters.
Oh my god. Please steer right momentarily, Mistress. Okay. Sweeping the sail, do. Oh, okay. Close me down. I see the force of the river is fastest in the middle, Mistress. Okay. I think it makes me go quicker or slower. On the surface, it appears the same, but there are deeper currents below. Follow the arrows, I guess. I'm in no hurry. I want to get there in one piece. Oh, here's the Verdant Pass. We were going the right way. Sneak it into the middle, maybe? There we go. Oh, there's a rock. Let's not hit a rock. Oh, there's another rock. Ah! I can drive. It's fine. Look. Look. We all know I'm a good driver. Ah, typical. That's Mesri. You can see the greenery from here. Mesri, a farming moon. If Renbar's here, I need to find him. And if he's not, I need to work out where he went.
we stepped off the ship and into the mud. Mud covered the ground and rock. And everywhere I looked, things were growing from the mud. And some of those things had legs.
Look at this place. Breathe the air.
I cannot breathe, Mistress. God damn it, robot. But rest assured, I am most happy for you, all the same. Well then. Let's see where Renbar's got to. If we're really lucky, he'll have found an old pot. So where do we start? There is a series of rice terraces. If we climb up away from the water, that should take us to the village. Okay. Well, I'm afraid that this is where I'm going to have to... Is there actually a pause menu here? Yes. I'm afraid this is where I'm going to have to end the first episode. This was an experiment. I wasn't sure how this was going to play, and hopefully it plays well enough for you to enjoy the episode. It's kind of a pilot episode. Let me know down in the comments below if you want to see more. Otherwise, I'll just play this in my own time. I really did in my head. But if you guys want to see more, I will do another episode on it. And maybe we'll finish it. Who knows? But the atmosphere of this game seems very interesting. The music is beautiful. The art style is interesting. So I like it. I'd just like to know what you think. So, thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe. Let me know. I think your comments are greatly appreciated. And as always, I'll see you next time.